So hello everybody, welcome to my talk. Thanks for being that late here. So I want to show you about developing industrial mixed reality applications with Unity. So I'm Oliver Schnabel, solutions engineer at Unity Technologies. And we used to be a game engine company, but these days with all these VR and AR and mixed reality headsets, a lot of people are using us outside of games. And to start the talk, I want to show you a small video what people are doing with Unity, both in games and non-gaming areas, as we call this. So I'm going to run a short showreel. So a lot of people are using us to create awesome content, and a lot of mobile games you're playing on your phones are actually made with Unity, more than 50%, 60% of all VR and AR apps, and that's stunning to run it on 2.75 billion devices last quarter. So it's a very huge amount of devices. And actually, all the demos you like here for HoloLens, you're seeing in the aquariums, actually 91% of all HoloLens apps are created in Unity. And all the major platforms we are supporting, so you can build on any platform, on any device. So is it a desktop PC or a Mac mobile consoles like Xbox One or PlayStation, or all the AR/VR platforms? So you don't have to decide which device you are targeting or which platform, you can just build it in Unity. And that's also true for the mixed reality headsets from Microsoft. So both for the immersive ones and the HoloLens, they are fully supported in Unity, and you have to develop once and can deploy it with the power of UWP Universal Windows Platform to all these headsets easily. And because of all these AR and VR devices, Unity is now used heavily outside of games, like in the automotive industry where I used to work for. So I was working at Volkswagen for the last 6 years, and they were using Unity heavily in the engineering process to train workers and to simulate stuff. Or in the film industry, people use Unity. And so what we bring you is all the powerful games we created for game persons or studios, and bring this to every developer, even if he is doing non-gaming applications or industrial applications. And with all the benefits what come from games is, for example, the stability of the runtime. So Unity is, was installed on 24 billion downloads last year. So it's running on nearly every device and a very huge amount. And you can use your favorite language like C# to write high-performance code, leveraging both the CPU and the GPU of the device. And as I said, you can deploy it afterwards to any platform on any device. And with these initiatives, we now create dedicated teams focusing on non-gaming applications. I'm the expert for automotive, but we have experts all around the globe for all the other use cases you want to build, which are not games. And a lot of people are building Unity applications for supporting their workflows or showing their products or their engineering. And so CAD support is very important for a lot of people. And that's why we partner up with a company called Pixies from France. And with the power of them, we can support more than 30 CAD formats directly, natively in Unity. So you can integrate CATIA files, JTs, IGES, whatever you want. And have a powerful tool to reduce the polygons, to calculate NURBS to polygons and use them inside Unity. And you can do this both manually, you can script it with Python code, so you have a fully automatic process that's possible. And you can also load cat files into the runtime you create with Unity. That's PC only, so only on Windows, because when you think about the HoloLens, it's a mobile device, so it's not from the memory and the CPU leverage. It's not possible to tessellate the data on the device, but on powerful PCs, you can actually do this. And you can use Unity to create HoloLens applications very easily based on your cut files. So when you have a client or 3D files from your company and want to create applications around it for the HoloLens, it's very easy to do so, and I want to show it to you now. So I'm going to run a demo. So I have here my Unity editor open, and let's imagine I'm working for a company selling brakes for automotive stuff. So I have here my Unity editor with a blank scene, and I already installed the Pixies plugin, which is found here, and Microsoft's Mixed Reality Toolkit, which is an open source toolkit you can download from GitHub directly, and it's setting you a lot of tools to develop for mixed reality. And the first step, what I'm going to do is I'm going to configure my project so that it's able to support both HoloLens and the immersive headsets. So I'm applying these settings now. And the next, I want to set up my scene so that it's good for HoloLens and VR. So I say apply mixed reality scene settings now. And what it's doing, it's actually preparing some objects in the scene so that, for example, the camera, when you start your application, is on 000, so in the coordinate system. And so you are good to go. And what you also find here is a camera prefab. So it decides, am I currently running on a HoloLens or am I currently running on an immersive opaque display? So you just create your app once and you don't have to think about this anymore. And now what I can do with the Pixies menu here is just click Import Cat, search for my cat file, which I got from the department, which is here a CATIA file, a cat product. So without leaving Unity, I can natively integrate them without switching the tool or anything. I just click Open, and I decide to transfer all my objects, all my small parts of the assembly under one root object. I currently don't care about LODs, and because we are targeting HoloLens in this demo, I just set the settings to medium, so it's like tessellating it to a medium quality mesh. And now I press Import. And what it's doing, when you see this loading bar, it's actually loading the NURBS files into memory, tessellating it to meshes that you can use in Unity right away. So now the object is imported. And when I have a look there, there you go. So I have my cut file integrated. I want to rotate it a bit. And as I said, in 000 is currently my camera, so I want to move it 2 meters away. So it's actually, when I start the HoloLens application, it will be 2 meters in front of me. So since these colors, what you now see, are directly from the CAD product, so when an engineer decides, okay, this part is yellow because of his engineering metadata, he needs a color for this, but it's not like the real world color. So that's why we're going to assign better looking materials, which we want to use for visualization. And I just created a very small script which is doing that, which is just searching for names. And so I can show you the script. It's just a dictionary which is searching for names, because they are most of the time in CAD very standardized, and putting materials on. So when I now do this, I can actually recreate scripts that adjust the editor as I want to have them. So here I created custom tools. So you can use C# to actually modify the Unity editor to your needs. So whenever you need a tool, you just write a C# script and can adjust the Unity editor. And what I'm now going to do is assign materials. So now it's looking already a bit better. So we have like metal and a paint here. And I'm going to do a skybox for lighting my brakes here. So what you see above is the editor view, and this is the game view, what I would see later on. And now I want to do interactions with this file. So imagine on a HoloLens, you could use your hand gestures to do an explosion and examine the cat files. So what I do for this is I move the center points of each object into the center of the whole breaks, and it's another small script I created. I just called it adjust hierarchy, and now every single screw and every single part has the origin in the same center, so I'm able to animate it very easily. So for LODs, I don't care right now, so I will remove this. So I want to do interactions now based on my hand gestures on the HoloLens. So I'm creating an area where I want to do this. So I created a cube which is 1 by 1 by 1 meter. And when I look at this cube, it's around the breaks, I can use my hand gesture to interact with. So I don't want to show this cube, I remove the renderer here. So I just have the bounding volume. And then I will drop my breaks under this cube. So what I now have is interactable component to actually interact with my hand gestures. And therefore, I created another script, which is basically just searching for the hand gestures. And when the event of an air tap comes, I can calculate the distance. When I move my finger left and right, I will explode the cat file, which I got from a colleague, for example. And when I now press play, it's simulating like my app running inside the Unity editor. And you see the small hands underneath, so I can also simulate gestures. So when I press space, you see the right hand shows up. And now I can do the gesture and do a cat animation automatically. So basically, what we now have is an interactive application created in like 5 minutes based on any cat file. And you can right away save this now. Calling this live demo. And now build this for HoloLens. So I'm just choosing the folder where I want to build it. And it's actually creating a UWP app out of it. And you can deploy it directly to your HoloLens and also use it in VR. On HoloLens, you will just see the brakes. In VR, you will also see the parking spot, what I just dropped in the background. So to recap this, before it was very hard to bring cat data into Unity. So it's just not a games format. It's from the engineering world, and we are coming from the games world. And that's why we are partnering together with Pixies to bring the cat files into Unity as well to create these awesome VR and AR experiences. You can actually also download the cat file, which I showed, the breaks, also on the Pixies website. So when you go there, you can have a cat file which you can try and work with. You get the Pixies plugin for Unity. And in the demo, I also used the Microsoft Mixed Reality Toolkit, which you find on GitHub, which you should use to work with HoloLens and have a lot of scripts which will help you to create interactive applications. And the last step was I just created a build out of it so that you can deploy it right away. And that's under 5 minutes. I didn't have a counter like in the keynote, but I would say it was like under 5 minutes. More into detail will go my colleague tomorrow, Peter, at 10:30. So he will show you all the new features which we are providing for Unity with mixed reality. There are also new features which are just released this or last week. You should definitely check out this talk. Another talk I can advise you is from René. He's also using the HoloLens, creating Unity applications with the power of machine learning. So I definitely advise you to go there, because you have a lot of lessons learned what they created with Unity applications. And you should go to our booth at E21, where we have colleagues from Pixies and from Unity. And you can ask any questions what you have. And we can show you much more details and the powerful polygon reduction tools we provide, and all the questions you have. So to summarize, with Unity for Industrial, we bundle you all the best tools we created for games. We add the full cut support, so you can actually create your applications around your already existing data, and you don't have to take care about like which tools you need. So like complicated tool chains, you can directly, without leaving the Unity editor, you can drop them in. We also have dedicated teams worldwide. I am located in Germany. We have resources here in the US and Asia, so all around the world. So we are happy to support you on all the applications you are creating. And with this power, you can actually create for mixed reality, both for HoloLens and immersive. And you should do so, because it's a very awesome experience you can create. And it's a growing market, and it's very well adopted in the industry. So when you want to work with big customers, they are searching for actually Unity developers to create experience for them. So when you want to work as a developer for big names or brands, they are really investing a lot into this space. And also, you should evaluate this session and give me some feedback. And I think we also have some time for questions. So if anyone has questions. We have a mic for questions? OK. Yes, I think so. Yeah. About Rhino format. Yeah, I think it's supported, but you should come to our booth and ask. So the Pixies guys, yeah. I'm thinking about. So maybe you can drop me an email, and we will open source them later. But I will put them in a repository. Yeah. Ah, again. So so the question was if they can get the scripts. So we will put it on in our tutorial section. So, but it's very small script, so nothing special. So, other questions? Okay. And you can also come to our booth and ask us anything. And thanks for your time.